Welcome back to Let's Play Life is Strange 2. I'm now beginning episode 4, Faith. The choices kind of spoiled the outcome of the ending, which you couldn't really see. Couldn't really tell. That and the outro, I guess, for the game? Epilogue? The short epilogue? Apparently, Daniel is who knows where, gone, AWOL. Gotta find him. Cassidy is injured. Not dead. What's his name? The guy. I can't remember his name. He is not dead. Other than that, I couldn't really tell you that much. Daniel used his powers, and the place exploded. So now beginning episode 4, Faith. We've yet to come to inside the, what do you call it, the plant, the marijuana farm. So I don't know if it's going to pick up there or just at another location. In any case, last
Once
episode.
Upon a time,
best ever.
In a wild, wild world.
Mm-hmm.
There were two wolf brothers living in their home lair with their papa wolf. They lived in peace until hunters took their dad away. And they had to go on the run. That's when the big brother discovered that the little one was not an ordinary wolf, but a super wolf. They discovered a secret hideout where they could train day and night. They were happy. But the little wolf got very sick, and they had to move on. The brothers made it to the home of their ancestors, and the old wolves took care of them. Unfortunately, the hunters were hot on their trail and found them. The brothers had nowhere to stay again, so they decided to keep going south. They soon entered the old forest of the giants, where they met a pack of stray dogs who worked in a secret farm.
Mm-hmm.
The brothers joined them and worked hard to stock up on gold for the future. They were happy to find others like them, and everybody loved the little wolf, who was growing up fast. His power was growing too. The little wolf was more and more confident and independent. The big brother hooked up with a cool she-dog.
Haha.
They had their own adventures. Suddenly, the mean farmers who owned the land tried to hurt the brothers. The little cub was injured. He transformed into a super wolf and destroyed everything. The big brother was badly wounded. And worse, he didn't know where the little cub was.
The analogy kind of falls apart when you find that the wolves are working on a farm and need gold. But hey, I like it. I like these little wolfy, wolf-like recaps. Looks like back at the first place they found with the picnic area and the lake. Guess it is. Another flashback.
Hey, yeah. Sean.
That's his old shirt.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. It was a bad idea.
Daniel. No way. It's all good.
Wish I listened when you tried to stop me from going with Finn. I was too pissed.
It's okay, dude. You're my brother. And that's all that counts.
So, why don't you come and get me?
He's dreaming.
Sean's, I'm alone, Sean.
Sean's dreaming.
I don't know what to do.
What, Daniel's dreaming?
I'm scared.
Don't get so close to that edge.
Please. Come and get me.
Yes, I swear. Stop!
Ooh, he's in the hospital. Did they find out who he is? If they did, he'd probably be handcuffed to the gurney there. A hospital in Northern California, 2 months after the blast at Merrill's. Wow. Missing for that long. Was separated for that long, rather.
Fuck.
Where's Cassidy?
Daniel.
And Finn. I was trying to remember his name.
I keep having these nightmares since I came out of the coma.
Agent Flores? Oh, brother. Alright, let's look at stuff and then we'll see his inventory. Agent Flores' card.
Yeah. Thanks for the card, Agent. Can't wait to text you.
U.S. Department of Justice, Federal Bureau of Investigation, FBI, Maria Elena Flores, Special Agent, Seattle Division. Call anytime, day or night, if you want to talk. SAF? Oh, Special Agent F. So why isn't he restrained? They obviously found him.
Can't catch shit. Zero depth perception. Goodbye, sports.
I mean, maybe he's free to get up. In case he has to use the bathroom, too. There might be someone posted right outside the door there. Leftovers?
This must be my punishment. Haha. Can't even focus on the page. This sucks ass, man.
Better off doing this. March 26th, 2017. Was in a coma for weeks, blind and screwed, and in police custody, going to jail soon. Hospitals freak me out. Hate this. Where's Daniel? I'm scared. That's horrible. March 30th. So that was the 27th. Or 26th. Yeah, 4 days later. Try to draw to kill time. This room is like a cage, but I suck now. No depth perception, no art, no crap. Focusing equals immediate migraine. Going crazy in here. Woke up crying. Yeah, his eye. Special Agent... Special Secret Agent Flores, April 3rd. She's trying to bond with me. Get it? Bond? Trap me or trust me. So screwed. Cops still can't find Daniel after the explosion, so he's out there alone? April 11th. Happy birthday, Daniel, wherever you are, enano, which I looked up means dwarf in Spanish. No wonder Daniel doesn't like being called that anymore. April 15th, Claire and Steven sent me a nice letter. Oh, yeah, grandparents. So lonely I read it twice. Weird how I missed them now. So cool to hear from Captain Spirit, too. Glad he's doing fine. That's awesome. My Joey sketch doesn't look bad. So glad he's around. All right, so we found out Chris is alive. That's sweet. That's awesome. I was afraid my, you know, whatever I did in episode 2 and or the Captain Spirit prelude ended up with him being killed because I did not complete all the objectives. I went back and recorded it, but after that I didn't continue on and finish the game, so the saved game has, I guess recorded at the end, has me with not completed 3 objectives. Didn't think of that. April 20th. Wish I could hear Cass play again. All those songs are gone, but not our time together. I wonder if he's heard from her. April 25th. I screwed Daniel up. I let Finn become his brother. Well, that's not your fault. Oh, Cassidy's letter. Alright, let's read Cassidy's letter.
I miss Cass so much. Wish I could hold her.
Howdy, city boy. But you're surprised to hear from me. I found out we were in the same hospital from the police after we were questioned when I was checked out a month ago. So I took the chance to write, and I hope you get this. Wish I could say everything I want, but you never know who's reading, right? If anybody else is reading this, screw you. I truly hope you're okay after what happened. As for me, I don't remember much except the explosion at Merrill's office, then I woke up in the hospital with blunt trauma, healing, and what the doctors call blast lung injury, hurting. Just glad that I can play guitar and sing, not that I feel like it. You learn a crap load about medicine stuck in a hospital bed. As I'm sure you know, my sweet compadre, still working on that Espanol, missed my lessons and my teacher. You probably know more about what's going on than me, but Hannah, Penny, and I were released without charges. The police were stoked to bust a farm of drug traffickers rather than us gutter punks toiling in the field. We asked about you and Daniel, but got no answers. Surprise. So with Finn and you gone, our rail family is kind of broken up. Well, they said Finn didn't die. Wait a second. Hannah, Penny, and I. What happened with Finn? So with Finn and you gone, our rail family is kind of broken up. Now we're just a lonely trio, train hopping up and down the state, but it feels like we're going in a loop to nowhere. Hannah and Penny aren't the same, and we fight too much. I'm not even sure we'll be together for much longer. Stuff changes, right? Maybe I'll have a new set of blues songs for the road. I know you're going to trial soon over the Seattle situation, and you will get the justice and freedom you deserve. Huh? You sure about that? You and Daniel are amazing brothers, and I hope you find your way home soon. I hope we can swim naked again under a new moonlight. It's a big world, and maybe we'll meet again someday. I'll always be singing your song, Love and Peace, Cassidy. I like to read it in the native scrawl, if it is legible. Oh, it's the tattoo she gave him. Well. Alright, let me just take a look at whatever we have, which is probably nothing. Souvenirs. Objectives, call the nurse.
This day feels like every other day. Just like prison.
Yep.
Yay. Stupid reality shows.
Is it blank so that we don't have a content ID? Because I do have that taken out, but I figured that was just music. So let's draw. Then we'll call the nurse. gonna hurt his eye. Or his head, or both.
So hard to focus. Gotta practice way more. Not giving up.
Did he lose his eye forever?
I guess that's an okay start. But I can keep going.
Yep, here we go. Draw a staircase. When am I supposed to find that? Oh, like a staircase out of here? Staircase to heaven, looks like.
Wish I could find a highway to freedom.
Trying to be more hopeful. Call Joey. Is Joey the nurse then? What was that? Letters?
Glad Stephen's leg is better. Must be tough on Claire.
Okay. From grandparents. This one's easier with this. Sean, we are grateful to find out that you are safe and awake. The police contacted us when you were found unconscious in Humboldt County. We weren't about to visit you in the hospital. We want you to recover ASAP. The doctors say that you woke up from that coma stronger than before. The most important thing now is to find Daniel. We are helping the police any way we can. They really want to help find him too, Sean. Hopefully this reflects well during your trial. Am I going to have to play through a trial? Crap. We know this must be hard for you after everything you and your brother have been through. You're both in our thoughts and prayers every day and night. Remember, you are our family and we love you. We hope to visit you and Jolena Shore as soon as we can. Take care, Claire and Stephen. P.S. Chris insisted to write a little note. It's attached to this letter. He doesn't know Daniel is missing. Is that like a real place? Hold on. Jolena. Oh. Jolena. Sure. Still in go. Oh, I'm actually coming up with Life is Strange Wiki. I think it might be a made up place. Yeah. Long Beach? Oh, wait. I come up with a news article. Hold on. Shore is not found as a word in the article. So, other than that, I'm getting results for Life is Strange 2, so I'm guessing it's a made-up town, city, whatever, in California must still be. So here's Chris's letter.
So glad Chris is okay. That kid is a real superhero on his own.
Hi, Sean and Daniel. I hope you are okay. I am fine, but I miss both of you a lot. After my accident, I had to wear a stupid cast forever. Is everyone going to the hospital getting hurt over here? I was trapped in my room all winter. Sucks. But summer is here, and I can play again. All the snow is gone. You should come back to see Beaver Creek without the snow. I'll be waiting for you, Chris and Captain Spirit. P.S. We need to save Beaver Creek from swamp bugs. Okie dokie. Well, I'm glad I read that, because I kind of almost missed it next to that letter. I want to make sure I don't miss anything else. No. Okay.
I'm supposed to call the nurse when I'm done eating. Guess I'm done.
You want the cookie? You don't want the cookie? You don't eat the cookie, you can't get the nookie. Tap tap. The world's been overtaken by zombies. So now we... the guard is gone and we can escape from here. Just like the beginning of, The Walking Dead and 28 Days Later. The only difference is...
man, this room drives me nuts.
You're already nuts,
talking
man.
Talking to someone would be at least... a change.
Yeah, well, Joey's not answering.
Joey must hate the sound of this thing.
Yo!
Afternoon yo, yo! Checkup. Yo, Joe! Yeah, they got someone parked at the door.
Good day, sunshine.
Standing guard.
Hey, Joey.
What's that?
Hey, man.
Oh, getting along good, at least, with him.
That looks like it might have been food. Hard to tell.
Ha ha. Never heard that before.
Oh, somebody is in a bad mood.
Sorry, Joey. Not feeling it today.
I don't blame you.
It's fine a second ago.
But maybe I got something to cheer you up.
Pecans and chocolate?
Uh-oh. There's that smile.
Thanks, Joey.
So how you feeling today? Any headaches? Socket pain?
No. It's all good.
Well, this is your final test before... you know. Before they... check you out.
Check me out to Julie. Yeah.
Kinda get out the window.
Okay, let's see. You know the drill. Don't blink and just stare at the light.
Isn't he 17? Shouldn't be juvie anymore.
Yes. Nice retina response. Okay. Now, try to follow the light as well as you can. Come on, Sean.
Okay.
You've been there before.
I just...
good, good. Keep going.
I don't know which way you're gonna go.
Quick response. Nice. Remember, to see objects on your left side, you gotta turn your head more now.
Okay.
Yes. Looking good, Sean. Now try to align your pen with mine.
Is this eye permanently
gone? Try.
I guess.
No rush. This is tough. Your depth perception will always be affected, so you gotta try harder.
Shit.
He lost his eye forever.
Yeah, I know. It's hard.
Come on.
Wait. Hold this to lock the view. When locked...
yeah, that's enough. Too much stress on you and your eye. But remember, your depth perception will always be affected.
I don't know how to move it forward.
Here, read this.
Patient cleared. I am a pirate.
I'm a pirate without a patch. Arrrr.
I'd be more worried if you weren't such a smartass. You can try, but you can't rig the exam, Sean. It's time we release you. Sorry. Your vision has improved a lot. Now you don't really have severe side effects anymore.
Yeah. That's just great.
I do have to tell them the truth. But first, let's clean this dressing.
Hey, sure hope you're watching the door like your phone. Oh,
come on. He ain't going nowhere.
Great.
All I do is watch him.
Yes, true. Your job.
Oh, boy.
Do you mind if we talk alone?
Mind if I finish with my patient?
I mind.
He looks good for now, right? Just come back when I'm finished with him.
bossy.
Sure. I'll swing by later, Sean.
Okay. I like that the guard doesn't pay attention.
Stay cool.
Maybe we can use that. Take advantage of that. Gotta get out of here. Find Daniel. Can't find Daniel if we're in jail.
So, how are you feeling today, Mr. Diaz?
Amazing. Did you find Daniel?
I want to go over this again.
What?
You know?
I've been telling the same fucking story for 3 weeks. How much longer?
Until it makes sense. Until you get it right. So, silence isn't gonna help you now. Listen close, Sean. Tomorrow you're going to Jolina Shore and you'll be arraigned in court for the murder of a Seattle police officer. You might spend the rest of your life in prison, or you can talk to me.
I'm innocent until proven guilty.
I'm innocent until proven guilty, right?
And I believe that. That's why I want you to tell me the whole truth.
It's just, I can't.
Was Daniel involved? Is that why you can't talk?
No, no way.
And you're absolutely sure your dad didn't go after the officer?
You kidding?
Are you shitting me? That officer freaked out and shot him! In front of me and Daniel! Just guilty of being... who knows?
I hear you, but...
Caucasian.
You're sure you didn't get upset and go after the officer? It happens.
Jesus.
Remember that?
Look at me.
Okay, let's just jump ahead. Tell me what happened in that farm in Humboldt. The place looks like a tornado wiped it out.
I've told you so many times. I have no clue why the place was trashed. I passed out.
Plus 3 seriously wounded, along with you. And a missing child. Nobody's statement matches with each other. Sean, throw me a bone here.
I wonder if any of them are saying that Daniel had powers. You know, even if they wanted to say something like that, that had to be run through their minds. Who would even believe them that that would be a thing? Oh yeah, he used telekinesis and destroyed the place. Who would believe that, right?
Can't you see I want to help?
So you haven't found my brother?
We might have some leads.
Might.
You can help by telling me the truth.
It's not going to lead you there.
Okay. Fuck.
The robbery. Whose idea was it? His? Or yours? Huh?
Is that... It was Finn. Is Finn being held too?
Finn. It was his idea to rip off Meryl.
Did he force you to help? Or did you go along with it?
He lied. Yeah, I'm just gonna give him up. I don't care.
He lied. I didn't want to help.
It's his fault.
But he got Daniel involved.
Yeah.
I swear.
All bets
are off. Swear. I didn't think anything like this was gonna happen.
In general, I would not want to... Sorry to keep pausing it. In general, I would not want to just give up Finn like this. But... It's his fault. This is all his fault. He said no, and then he snuck and took his own brother, Sean's brother, a 9-year-old, to a place that would be dangerous, and sure enough, it was dangerous, and you see what happened. So that's all Finn's fault. That's on him. He came from jail. I guess he's going back to jail. Sorry, Finn. Learn for next time. Stop thinking of yourself.
Nobody does, Sean. Until it's too late.
Yeah. Now I know.
And what about Cassidy? She planned all this with Finn?
No. She was against it. Yeah, exactly what I was gonna say before I even read it.
She was against this stupid plan. She had nothing to do with it.
Your friends are learning the hard way.
They didn't deserve it.
They didn't deserve it. We all make mistakes.
Yeah, Well, some mistakes are worse than others. By the way, we contacted your grandparents in Beaver Creek. They can visit you after you're transferred. Might be a while, but you do have a support group. We couldn't track down your mother, though. Sorry.
Hmm. Good. What about Daniel? You just said you had leads.
Mother's hard
to find. I said might. Hold on. I gotta take this call.
Alright, now we bust out of here. Get the hell out of here.
Sorry, Finn. That's just karma for dragging Daniel into this shit.
That's true.
She didn't want anything to do with this.
Lucy? Her name's not Cassie at all. Lucy Rose Jones. Photo taken February 26th.
Wonder what Merrill told the cops about the robbery.
I thought he died. I thought he died in this. Guess I assumed, and I assumed wrong.
Sorry, Hannah. She lost her family for this. Hope the cops didn't mess with Penny. Prison would fuck him up.
Real name, Baptiste Dean McHale. Yeah. Unless he was put in like a solitary or like a ward for like LGBT or something like that, that would be an issue. Definitely.
Lotus?
Let's also look at her.
Hi. You have me call. Everything okay?
Can I get up?
Well, if you said enough, then enough. You know the rules, son. No, honey. I told you I was going to be away for a while. I'm sorry, okay? You gotta be good. Okay. Bonella, will you down the phone, please? Love you.
Sounds like she was talking to her kid. No objectives.
Sorry, Finn. That's just karma for dragging Daniel into this shit.
I didn't think he'd say that again. But I don't understand what she's saying.
Sorry about that. Okay.
He's better at the Espanol than I am. Much better.
So what's going on with Daniel? You really have leads?
Yes, we do. That's our job. The Bureau put his profile out over 4 states.
So Nat might have leads. Now she says she does have leads.
So we are on the case.
You lied to me.
You lied to me. You have no leads. You have no fucking idea where my brother is.
I don't lie, Sean. But you did. And your brother is paying the price.
Fuck. You. I'm done.
Anyway. Thanks for talking to me. I'll be back tomorrow to take you to Jolina Shore.
Can't wait. I'll be bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. Gotta get out of here. Jump out the window. Is there a tree down there you can grab onto?
Look out! I have to guard the guard now. Love it.
Huh.
Sit down so we can get this show going. So, how did your interview with Scully go?
Scully, you mean interrogation?
You mean interrogation?
Why is it Who knows? Phrase?
Maybe Detective Flores wants to help. Maybe not. I just can't trust her.
After what you and your brother went through, I don't blame you. Oh, this shit is all wrong, man. You've been out of the garden for 3 weeks now. We talk every day. I can see that you're a good person.
Can I help us? Thank you.
Thanks, Joey. Want to tell that to the judges?
I'm just saying, you don't deserve this. Now let's check this out. The healing is coming along nice. Just gotta keep it clean for the next week or so.
Will he?
Simple.
That's great.
Seen the shrink this morning? What did she say?
Nothing I want to hear. This will take time and rehab, Sean. You have to process first. Ugh. I could tell myself that shit.
Clearly, I'm no therapist, but I've nursed patients with your injury. They all turned their anger into energy. You will too. Plus, the glass eye tech is pretty cool now.
Oh, okay. Glass
things
eye.
Things change, Sean.
He's not gonna get his sight back. Jail for life.
Yeah. Stuck in jail is a big change. Can't wait. Sorry, Joey. I'm being a dickhead. Just bummed out.
I know. I do. But I promise there's a treat coming your way.
A treat?
Now, as for your wound, this is the last time you hear this from me. You have to clean it with sterile gauze and saline solution.
That stinks. He lost his eye. Horrible. Hard to fire a gunner and do stuff without that.
Coat the area using the swab and cream. Then wrap it up with clean dressing. And you're the shit. Remember, you gotta do this.
4 times a day.
Wow.
I won't forget.
I'm sorry about everything, Sean. Wish I could have done more.
Dude,
help me
get
out.
You saved my ass here. You're the only one I trust. It really helped.
Cool. I'm glad when I can make a check. Oh, shit. Emergency. I'm out. And no smoke break. Let's say our goodbye tomorrow. Oh, Sean, check out that towel. Got your name all over it. Catch you later.
Is there something in the towel that'll help us escape? You got a key for the window?
Joey. You are her boss.
I'll check the towel last. I have a feeling there's something that might help us there.
Yay. Stupid reality shows.
Same thing he said before. Joey's pen.
Joey's the only one who helped me get through this shit.
Take. You could use it to stab the guard in the neck.